a teraz w ramach 20. uroczystych zaduszek jazzowych prezentuje zespół Margi, teraz i tu.
Thank you so much. I think we're doctors or something. Anyway, we're Marvin. This is called Musty Marvin.
We'll be right back.
Thank you so very much. That song is called Messy Mark. We're going to play one now called Cheap Joint. We'll be right back. Alrighty, so we're gonna play a song now called Fisticuffs. Now, we have a shirt set, usually I'm more talkative, but I'm gonna tell you a story. You see, a lot of times people ask us how we come up with our song titles, you know, how we name our songs. With instrumental music, that's a hard thing to do because our music doesn't mean anything. And what musicians do to compensate for that thing is that they start hallucinating when they name songs. People will get together in the room, the process looks like this, right? They'll put the song on, one person listens, he goes together, sounds like the ocean, dude. And then another one goes like tidal wave. And then they're really happy. We don't do any of that bullshit. We go out on the road for about 300 days a year and we get to see a lot of crazy motherfuckers do a lot of crazy shit. And we name all of our songs to commemorate these evenings we barely survived. So, that's true. So that's the song we're about to play, Fisticuffs, happened in Eureka Springs, Arkansas. Anybody know what that is? Probably not, right? Yeah, one person. Alright, the rest of you don't go. So the first time we ever played there, we walk into this bar called the Squid and Whale, and we have an opening act. His name is Aiden Waters. He's standing there like playing the 12-string guitar, singing covers, and he gets done with his set, and we go on and we play our set. And Aiden fucking loves us, like a little bit too much, but we don't know it at the time. Anyway, he comes to the stage with a tray full of shots, and he goes, "Fellas, I got you guys shots." And we're like, "Fuck yeah, we love shots." So we take the shots. Boom, 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 boom. Shots taken. We're really happy. He starts chatting us up. He's sweet. He's funny. We love Dayton. Dayton loves us. All is good. Until I get this bright idea to go and get Dayton a shot. So I march over to the bar and I get, you know, a shot from the bartender lady and I walk it back to Dayton and I go, "Dayton, here's a shot for you." And he looks at the shot and looks at me and he goes, "No, it's okay." And I'm like, "No." And he's like, "No, it's okay." So I triple insist, and Dayton looks at me, looks at the shot, looks at me, looks at the shot, and goes, "You know what? Fuck it." Bow. Takes it. Now, the bartender lady that knows Dayton just springs out, and I look at her, and she goes like, "No." So I'm standing there like, "I think Dayton has a problem." And he did, a big one. So anyway, Dayton marches over to the bar like Waylon Jennings, right? He sits himself down and he orders a full bottle of Jack Daniels and gets a shot glass. And he starts pounding shots like in time, like a metronome, just like pow, 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 pow. And he has all of our, you know, we're playing our second set and this guy has our attention. We're just looking at the guy like, "Look, dude, go," right? And he's pounding shots. Now, drinking that much whiskey that fast makes you a marketing genius. He goes to the doorway and he starts grabbing people from the street by the shirt into our show one by one, just like that. So we're standing there playing a fusion show, watching the whole room getting filled with terrified pedestrians who don't understand what the fuck they're doing at a fusion show. And I'm thinking, this is amazing. We need like four Daytons, we're gonna be famous in 1 week, right? It's a great marketing tool. Except for one detail. That guy would not stop drinking. So we get done with our second set, and at this point, Dayton is fucked up, right? And he can remember in the depths of his psyche his love for Marvin, because he starts charging us like a bear, right? Just like super aggressive, like, rah! Now, ladies, you girls can't relate to this, but when a grown man feels another grown man's cheek stubble just brushing against his own cheek, it flashes his mind back to being a baby. I think it's like the first hug your dad ever gave you coming back. But when it's not your dad, that shit is terrifying. So we spend the rest of the night just dodging, left dodging, right, trying to avoid it. At a certain point, he passes out forehead first on the bar, right? And we're like, this is our opening. We pack up the van. We're driving a full mile to the hotel we're staying in. So we get to the hotel, and we're not ready for bed yet. So we're blasting music in the parking lot from our van. We wake up this shirtless, like, redneck dude. And he comes down screaming at us, and he goes like, "What the fuck are you guys doing here? It's 3 a.m, music, neighbors, blah, blah, blah," right? So we get out of the car to just apologize, and at night, civilly, go to bed. That's the plan. But then we see Dave running from the bushes, right? And he's running, and he throws this right cross, like this punch, and it just goes, pow, into neighbor dude's jaw. And neighbor dude is out, right? He's passed out on the floor, and Dayton's hovering above him, and full-on 20s English boxer fisticuffs, which are all just seen like in real life for the first time right then. And he says this, and I quote, "You don't talk to Marvin like that." And we're just standing like, I guess you fucking don't. And And that was pretty awesome. So at a certain, he kicks it up a whole notch. Okay, he starts saying this catchphrase like, "You're not good enough. You're not good enough. You're not good enough." Well, he woke the dude up, and the dude got up, and he was very good. He jumped up in the air like Karate Kid and kicked poor Dayton straight in the mouth. And now Dayton goes passing out. So he's probably dead, but we got this great song title out of it. This is Fisticuffs. Thank you so very much. This next song is called Just a Little Bit.
Thank you.
so we're gonna play one last song for you guys. And after that, right at the lobby, we hijacked a little booth area and we're selling our merch. So we have 7 albums, we have our vinyl here today, we have shirts, we do take cards, come talk to us for all your merch needs. Once again, we are Marvin. Thank you, Poland, I guess, for having us. No, we appreciate each and every one of you. This is a great festival. And this last song we're going to play is called African Shop Time.
Thank you.
artystów muzycznych, które można wyobrazić w ciągu pół godziny. Marni, wielkie brawo! Tak, zespół powiedział merchandise is in the house, a więc 7 płyt, włącznie z winylami, koszulkami, innymi gadżetami zespołu w wejściu do Shopping Theater. Panie i panowie, drodzy zebrani, to będzie krótka przerwa na to, żeby wymienić instrumenty i za chwilę przed wami na wielkiej scenie 20. zaduszek jazzowych, nie kto inny, tylko nasza Karolina Baran, Kajla! Dla Marmina jeszcze wielkie brawo, jeszcze raz. Dawno nie słyszałem tak poważnej porcji muzyki, tak jak powiedziałem, w ciągu pół godziny usłyszeliśmy wszystko, po prostu wszystko, od samego początku do samego końca.